Hi, I'm back with another video. This time it's another unboxing. A couple of weeks ago, you'll remember I did a big geek sort of game unboxing with some Vita stuff. This time it's a dedicated Vita unboxing video. This time with a little bit of a twist. I'm going to look at some limited run game stuff because I've had a few over the last few months. And I'm going to possibly annoy a few of you this time, because I'm going to take a pile of limited run games I've had in the post recently, and I'm going to unbox them all. Literally. Starting with Antiquia Lost for the Vita. As you can see, this is still nice and sealed. Not anymore. So let's crack this one open to get started. I know this is something a lot of Vita owners who collect limited run games absolutely hate the idea of. Most people keep them sealed and stick to the digital copies. Not me, I open them to play. First one. Here we go. This one's a RPG from Kemco. Let's take a look inside. Just plain cartridge this time. Going in the Vita later. And that's what games are meant to be done. Buy them, open them, play them, enjoy them. Number two. Gunhouse. This is an update for the Vita from the PlayStation Mobile original. Not many people remember PlayStation Mobile. It was a great range of mini games that was kind of a spiritual successor to PlayStation Minis. Most people weren't bothered about them because they didn't have trophies. Missed out on a load of great games. Sony pulled the plug on the service, which was kind of disappointing really, because there were some fantastic games. Gunhouse was one of them. It got a native Vita update not long ago, and again, let's crack this one open. Sales wise for limited run games was quite disappointing. It actually stayed on sale for over a week after it was first released, so it didn't sell too well. Eventually it sold out, so now it's actually going to be quite a hard one to find again. Got to get on eBay to find it. Actually got a manual for this one. It's a side-scrolling shoot 'em up. Nice little manual. Mini comic strip at the back. I wasn't mad on the game, to be honest, on PlayStation Mobile. Some people enjoyed it. It's actually had an audio soundtrack release as well, on cassette of all things. But it's, again, nice little game to own for the collection. Next one, Phantom Breaker. I haven't actually played this one in digital or any other form for that matter, but again, let's crack. It sounds as if there's something else in this one, possibly a manual again. Not all Vita games, let alone LIG titles, have got manuals, but again, crack this one open. And, yep, another nice manual. Not too large. Looks like this is a RPG, but it's very small print at the back. I'm getting on a bit now, so it's going to be tough for my old eyes to read, but another one I'm looking forward to loading up and playing. And going by eBay prices, I've probably just opened about £120 worth of games. Next one, Hugh from Curve Digital. I've already got the digital version of this, so when I crack this one open, I'm going to delete it off my memory card, save myself a few hundred meg of space, which is going to be great. And I can imagine all the downvotes I'm going to get off this video when people actually start to watch it, which is, I actually don't mind. I'm hoping that you actually see this and realise games are meant to be fun, they're meant to be enjoyed. Just a game card again, but again, buy it, play it, enjoy it. And the same with all the other limited run games, anything that's being released physically from East Asia Soft, and any of these other limited companies. The same with PlayStation 4, if you buy these games, don't leave it sitting on the shelf, don't leave it sealed, just play it, have fun. 2064 Read Over Memories, this one sold out again lightning fast, and this one is going in the Vita. Not all straight away, as you can see, I've got a growing pile down here already, and I'm going to crack this beauty open. This one people were waiting for absolutely ages. It's a story driven RPG, and another nice little manual here. Presented a sort of a quite a small manual, to be honest. There's not a great deal to it, and a good comic book artwork in the middle. not much else to be honest, quite a flimsy little booklet there, but again, it's nice to have with a physical release. Next one, it's a bartender simulator, is the best way to describe it. Valhalla by Wolfgang, friends of ours who've been working on one of our Vita website, Vita Player, and Wolfgang Wozniak has been blogging on our site for quite some time about this game. Maybe if you've been a regular follower of our site, you'll have seen his regular updates on the progress of the release. Again, this is one I've actually been looking forward to for some time, and yeah, let's crack another one open. Again, just the game card, no manual. There's actually quite a good range of merchandise over on Fangamer to go with this one. And no, I'm not being paid to promote any of this stuff. But it was nice to see a game actually inspiring some extra stuff. But with the Fangamer stuff, I think, obviously being a bartending game, it produced some beer mats, some glasses, things like that. But it was quite cool that the game inspired stuff like that. Another one I've been waiting for a while was Race the Sun. It was cross-buy on the PS3, PS4, Vita, but again, it's another one hogging memory card space, so I just needed to free up a bit more. I've already got about 11 memory cards for the Vita, and all of those are full. I've got quite a large games collection as it is, but I just needed more space, so I just grabbed the chance to actually delete it off the cards. It's quite a fun sort of racing game, a little bit different. There we go again, no manual, just a game card, but that's all that matters, it's a chance to free up some card space and whack the game in. For any of you in the EU at this point or in Japan watching this video, if you buy any of these limited edition games, one thing to remember, if you've already got a save game on the digital copies, if you use PlayStation Plus to save your save data in ready to transfer games over to the physical copies, the physical copy must be from the same region as your digital copy or you'll lose your save data and it won't be compatible. One example, I had I bought the limited run version of Rainbow Moon. I'd been playing the digital version for quite some time, put about 20-30 hours into it, my save game data wasn't compatible, I had to start again from scratch. Not a bad thing with that game because it's a fantastic game, but I lost the save game data. Next one, Defender's Quest. This one was quite nice because it actually came with a map, which I'll open this one up. Obviously they couldn't put this in with the game itself, so this came separate in the envelope, but it came with quite a large map of the game world, which was a nice bonus to get. Obviously all of these came with the trading cards as I received them, but the game itself had the map, which was quite a nice bonus and something I wasn't expecting. Crack open the game and quite a weighty manual this time. Full instructions for the RPG. It's actually 32 page manual, so quite a hefty book as well. So a nice little package for that one. Obviously the game card. So one of the better value limited edition releases. Next one, Musinks. Rhythm game. Promises free music updates, and again this is one that was originally released for PlayStation Mobile. One of the bigger PlayStation Mobile releases, I think it weighed in at about 700-800 meg, taking up a huge amount of memory card space. There aren't many music games for the Vita, so it's worth getting just for that. Again, just a card only, but another great one to pick up, and probably one that's going to be more expensive on eBay if you need to get hold of this one. Still a few more to go. Senran Kagura Bon Appetit. The Senran Kagura games are very much a acquired taste. That's all I can really say on this one. Cookery meets anime meets, shall we say, scantily clad ladies. You either like this one or you don't. Personally, I hadn't bought the game on digital. I've already got the Senran Kagura S-Devil Versus, which is a beat-em-up. And if you've played any of the games before, you'll know what to expect. Just a mixture of cookery and risque sort of imagery. It's the best way I can describe it. Another brightly colourful manual. I haven't played it. It has been quite highly recommended, but I'll again play this when I get round to it. We will be doing some Vita reviews for the YouTube channel soon. I've got a capture card that's on its way in the next few days, so we'll be adding the Vita game reviews to the channel, which is something we've been looking forward to for a while, but we'll be coming into that another time. Next one, Dragon Sinker. Another RPG from Kemco. They've been releasing a lot of stuff for Vita lately, and they're still showing support, which is great, and they're coming out as physical as well. So, again, crack this one open. There was a slight tear on the seal on this one when it arrived, but which would have had some people up in arms, but again, me, I don't care. It's coming out of the box. No manual, just a game card, but I think I've gone through about a dozen games so far, so you can imagine there's people screaming at the TV, or the screen now, saying, how can you devalue all those games? They're worthless. They're not. You know, if you're paying, you're playing, you're having fun, you're getting your money's worth, that's all that matters. Next one, Project Zen and Valkyrie Plus. This one was developed by CoCat, who have released some really great games for the Vita, and this one's going to be no exception. Again, it feels a little bit weighty. I can hear some rattling inside, so let's crack it open. I think there's a manual in this one. And I think I've got absolutely hundreds of bits of wrapping paper on the floor now. Yep, another brightly coloured manual. Not particularly large, but still nice to actually get something inside, which, for those of you who up to the sort of PS2 era and PS1, manuals were a standard thing. It was great to actually have something physical. PS3, they started to sort of cut corners and have online manuals for games, which was really frustrating, especially when companies went bust, took servers offline. I was looking at one of my old PS2 games, PS3 games a couple of days ago. The manual was about 4 or 5 pages and then said the manual was online. The company's folded. If you want the instructions now, you've got no chance. The instructions have gone. And this is the thing why manuals are so important for games. Last one, and this is the big one. It's Night Trap. This came completely out of the blue when Limited Run Games announced this one. It's a Vita port of a Sega Mega CD classic from the 90s. Well, I say classic, it was a notorious video-only game. It's one of those love it or hate it games, but it's a kind of cool thing to have, really. It was a big experiment for Sega. It was basically sort of an interactive movie. Games like that had been done before then, and going back to a few years before Sega did this, but Night Trap was kind of the big one. But you've got the game itself and the manual. The video footage, I think, has been remastered. It's kind of a piece of history to own Night Trap, so it's kind of a nice one to own, and that's the last. And that's it. I've kind of gone through all of these, which is going to have most Limited Run Games collectors absolutely freaking out, realising that I just cracked open over a dozen Limited Run games in about 10 minutes. Well, that's it for this time. I will actually be reviewing some of these on the channel as soon as my video capture card comes along, and I'll be back very soon with another unboxing video. That's it for now, and thanks for watching.
Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to click on the like button and leave us a comment below. Also, spare a moment to share this video on Twitter, Facebook, and all your social media pages. To get updates on all of our latest videos delivered straight to your inbox, subscribe now using the link on the screen.